In this video, you're going to learn about how to create a very simple application against an Excel spreadsheet using Power Apps. So stay tuned. Every organization has tons of spreadsheets, likely in their environment. Now, in this video, we're going to show you how to create a Power App to automatically add new records, update records, delete records, and also do things like auto-incrementing of records as well. So we're starting at employee ID 1 and going incrementally down from there. We'll be using Power Apps today, so you can go into powerapps.com or make.powerapps.com to play along with the example today. I'm going to be pointing to a spreadsheet inside of OneDrive for Business. Let's actually launch it real quick so you can see it. You'll see I've got a list of fake employees here, with some crazy old years here in this case. Now, what I want to do is I want to go through and actually point to this. The reason I chose OneDrive for Business is because from there, I can store this, I can share it with others, and I can have a multitude of ways of getting to that spreadsheet also. It's also in the cloud as well. Because it's in the cloud, I have the ability to edit it right from Power Apps so I haven't installed any kind of a gateway device. So let's take a quick peek. Now ultimately, you'll see I have my list of employees, have my start dates, and I have an employee ID which looks to be auto-incrementing. So we're going to want to do the same thing inside of our application as well. So I've opened up web.powerapps.com. And at this point, I'm going to go ahead and create a brand new application. So we can go ahead and create a Canvas application, but we'll start with some data first. That's the fastest way to build an application. So once we do that, we'll go ahead and click on Start Data from Application, from Data, hit Create. This is going to open up the Maker Lab here for us, and you'll notice one of the sources we can get data from is the OneDrive for Business. Now notice the one we pull data from, we pull an app from Data in our case, it is going to use a phone layout. Now we can change that at a later time. Ones down here, the templates and the phone and then the blank apps can use tablet or phone devices, but in our case, because we are using a wizard here, it's going to start with a phone layout, and then we're going to change that at a later time to be more of a tablet layout also. So I'll go ahead and select phone layout, and it already pulled up my OneDrive for Business, so I'll hit create. Now because I'm signed in right now with my account, it should go ahead and use my authentication token to do that, and then, excuse me, and then pull a list of files, and there's my fake list right here. Now I did not give it an appropriate name. The default is going to be table 1 for the actual table. So that's what's pulling back from the spreadsheet you saw right here. That's the list of these three columns and X amount of rows. So if you want to give it a better name, you could actually do that under data, and you can give it a better name inside of this. I can't do it inside this web app though, unfortunately. All right, so we'll go ahead and point to table 1. And then we'll hit connect. Now it's building the application for us right now. This may take it anywhere from 5-10 seconds on up to 30-45 seconds, up to you. Now when it's done though, it's going to build the basic structure of an application for us. It'll build a structure of an app that can do things like reading, updating, deleting, and inserting of new records. I can save this application now also and publish it to where it's now available to edit this spreadsheet from a phone device, from things like Android, iOS, a Windows device, and also from SharePoint and inside of the web as well. So pretty easy to manage, and as you can see here, once we connect, we're able to see a list of records. Now it's getting a little bit of error right now because I have that spreadsheet open in another screen. I'll go ahead and close that spreadsheet out, hit refresh, and we should now get that row, those rows back. I held down the Alt key to do this refresh. So once we have our app there, we can either hit the play button to interact with it in the top right, or we can hold down the Alt key to interact with it also. That's one of the nice fast ways of doing things inside of Power Apps. But as you can see, we've got our basic application now done. And if I open up the spreadsheet inside of here again, there's a few alterations it's made to my data set now. The first alteration you'll notice is it created an ID inside of Excel for to uniquely identifying each record inside of Power Apps, so it knows which record to actually do updates on and all that. So that's the only alteration it didn't make. If it's not okay, probably Power Apps may not be the best answer for you, but kind of a cool way of uniquifying this record, because it doesn't know that 1 through 5 is a unique record. So back in my app here again, I want to be able to add new records, delete records. We can do things like sorting and searching for employees. A few things inside of here, you'll notice the search that we have. If I select the gallery, this is a gallery, and this gallery is a list of all the records we have. So if I select this gallery, we can see that it's sorting by columns. What column it's sorting on? It's sorting by the employee ID here, or by the employee column. And then you'll see how it's doing all the sorting here. So we can kind of sort vertically or horizontally. Now this happens to be a text column. That's why it's a little goofy on this way it's sorting. We won't get into that mess right now. But if you want to sort based on employee name, we can just simply go in here and change that to employee name, I believe I called it. I can't remember what the column is actually called. Okay, so let me put employee ID for the time being. There we go. But if we select this guy right here, Adam Jorgensen here, for example, we see it's actually called employee. So we can go back in here and just take that ID out. And in a moment, as we sort, we'll see Oliver Timms. Now Adam's, because he has an A, is now sorted up top. So this is how we can do this change of sort order. It's the employee entity. Oh, we're sorting by employee ID first. Actually, we're sorting by two columns here. Let me go ahead and take that one out. It's not needed anymore. So we're sorting by the employee name only. We could sort by multiple columns though, employee, and then do a comma, then then the start date, and so on and so on and so on. All right, with that now done, we can also see that we have things like searching ability here as well. See this search right here? This search is saying search by the employee name. So when I go and hit the play button here, and I do a search, okay, let me find my mouse here. If I, once I search for Brian, let me go up here. There we go. It easily searches based on the name there as well. Now here's how the code looks like. Now this code is automatically built for us, but if you want to change that, look at your gallery, select your gallery, and you'll see it's actually the gallery right here, and change what column on the outside. So you'll see here, it actually is looking at whatever's in the text box and searching based on the employee here. So the biggest gotcha is you'll have to see, well, which parentheses am I in right now? Am I looking at the parentheses on the outside or inside? The one I thought I was altering before was actually the search clause, not the sort clause. This is my sort right here. And you can see that because it's on the outside. So, and this is on the inside of the search. So I'm searching my employee name here. But I could search for multiple columns like employee name and then start date and so on. Now we're not actually gonna do that because it's not actually the column name, but you get the idea. Okay. So there's a few ways we can do it. You can see we can sort ascending or descending by selecting that little sort button right there. So it kind of recognizes what you clicked on. So this is our basic core application. Now, once you have this basic core application now written, we're ready to go ahead and do some additional things. Let me go ahead and change the way we do inserts. Let's first of all get rid of Brian here. And when I select Brian, for example, we see we can hit the pencil icon. And we're seeing the form to actually edit Brian's record. Well, a few gotchas here. I'm looking at this and I don't want to be able to edit the employee ID. So if I hit the escape key to get out of the preview mode, I can select this employee ID and I can say, I don't want to be able to see this employee ID. I don't want to be able to somebody to actually alter that. Because that's the equivalent of social security address at Pragmatic Works in my case. So I can select the employee ID text box, and one of the properties you'll notice when it creates this from the wizard, one of the things it's going to do is it locks in each of these fields. So I'll do this lock right here. If you want to customize this field in any way outside that form creator, you have to unlock each of these fields. And after you unlock that, you can then go through and specify what's the behavior you want for this. Now, all the way at the bottom here, it says more options in the advanced tab. You scroll down and you'll see the display mode listed here. Now, that's one way of doing it. The other way inside of Power Apps is simply go over to the left here, look for display mode. All right, there we go. Make sure your item is selected here. And right now it says parent.display mode. We can go ahead and say display mode dot, and we can say just do, and actually went ahead and dot view. Okay, so view essentially makes it a view-only field. You can see, but you can't touch. There's also the ability to hide that if you want to as well. But in most cases, you're likely going to want to see that field. And you can edit it either way, the top left or on the properties page on the right. So it's completely up to you. So now that we've done that, let's find out what happens when I want to go ahead and add a new record. So I can go ahead and change Brian. Let me go ahead and quickly run this app again. And I'm going to change Brian to Brian Knight 2, hit OK. And it's going to go ahead and send that update back. That's all there was to ultimately making that change. Now I have Brian Knight 2. Go back here. We can also go to Devonite and say, oh, I want to go ahead and get rid of Devonite. And now his record is gone. So really simple way to ultimately change the application. But when I add a new record, oh, here we go. Now we're looking at the same employee. I want to type in my new record. I'll call this Bubba Jones. And in this case, one of the gotchas is I don't have an employee ID, right? I want to go ahead and read what the last employee ID was and then add one to it. So that's a little gotcha here we have to do. So to do that, it's going to be a little different here. We're going to set the default value if it's ultimately in this one add mode here. So to do that, we're going to have to write a little bit of code here. Most of the code inside of Power Apps is very, very simple. But in this case, we're going to select this. Now we're looking for this time is going to be default. This is the default value we're going to pop inside of this. Okay. So we have to write an if-then statement. Now, the expression language for Power Apps is going to resemble the Excel language. So if you're an Excel administrator or a user, you'll be able to kind of manage inside of Power Apps pretty easily. Also, if you're a Power BI person, there's a lot of similarities there as well, because they kind of model that after Excel. So most of the code you're going to write are single lines of code. In this case, I just want to look at the Excel spreadsheet, find out the last ID, and add a 1 to it, increment it by 1 to ultimately set that. So let's go back here again, and let's change this default here and say, hey, if the mode I'm in is if I'm looking at a new record, I want to go ahead and add 1 to the last record in the database, or Excel spreadsheet in my case. Otherwise, just display the employee ID that's being passed in. So to do this, we'll go ahead and write an if statement. Notice up top here, it's kind of helping you write the code for you. So we'll say if edit mode. Now edit mode is going to say what mode is this form in. So sorry, edit form. That's the name of my form here. See on the left here, edit form is the name of my form. We ideally should name it a little better name, but this is just a wizard application, so we're gonna go forward here for the time being. If the edit form mode is equal to, now I wanna find out, am I actually creating a new record or am I updating? So to do that, there's this property here called form mode dot new. Now this is gonna specify, is this a new form? If it is, then we're gonna look inside of our table one. We call it a terrible name of table one, but give me the last table one record. Here we go. See, it's kind of writing for me here. And I want to get the employee ID from that and add 1. Oops, not employee, but employee ID. There we go. And add 1 to that. Otherwise, just show the employee ID. Okay, and close that down. So basically a basic if statement. Let me kind of zoom in a little closer here. So if the employee ID, if the form, to get rid of me so you can see the full thing here. If the form that we're actually editing right now, the form we're looking at right now, if it's in new mode, then go ahead and pull the last employee ID and add 1 to it. Otherwise, just show the existing employee ID. So if I were to go back, we're already seeing the value of 8 here. Let me go ahead and go into edit mode here. We should see 3. That's working perfectly. Oh, let me actually go the full distance here. We're seeing 3. So let's go ahead and run this again. And let's go ahead and add a new record. Again, we'll add Bubba Jones. We can also set a start date to be equal to today's date. There we go. Now it should be writing back record 8. There it is. There's Bubba Jones right there, number 8. It's helped sort of alphabetically. So let's do one more thing. I mentioned before we want to set the default date for that start date to be equal to today. Again, I need to unlock the value. And I want to set the default value again here as well. So default date, right now it says parent.default. Again, you're going to find it also under default date here. If we just go in here and type in now, open close parenthesis, there we go. We're getting today's date. So this is an easy way to kind of build today's date, and you can ultimately go through and fix that, and the customer can still override it, but it was a good starting point for now. All right, so now that we've got that, we're ready to go ahead and try this out one more time. Let's go ahead and run this again, and I'll call this one Davy Jones. He has an employee ID of 9 this time. We'll start that again. And now we're off to the races. So now we see Davy Jones and the D's is way down here. And if we go in and edit this again, we should see we can edit Davy Jones, but we can't actually change him. If I put an AAA in front, he should now sort to the top. There we go. Takes a few seconds because we are, again, this is just a good old fashioned, there's Davy Jones right there. This is just good old-fashioned wizard made, right? So at this point, we may want to make this a tablet application, right? So a few things to actually get this application you just built out to production. First of all, let's go ahead and save it. I'll go ahead and go to File and Save. It takes us right here. We'll call this just Excel app for the time being. We'll hit the Save button. Now, after you save that, though, our next step is to go ahead and publish it so other people can use it. So you'll find that under the Share This App. So when we hit Share This App, it'll also be called Publish after you've saved it a few times and you have multiple versions. I'll type in somebody I want to share it with, like Devin Knight. There we go. I'm going to uncheck. I don't want to send him an email notification right now. And it's going to prompt him, hey, do you want to share access to this Excel spreadsheet and all this once he opens up the spreadsheet? Once he opens us up for the first time. Excuse me, I stumbled over my words right now. So now Devin has access to this as well. So as I save this again, let me go back to edit mode one more time here. And every time I save this application, I already have it open. Excuse me. Here we go. Okay. There it is. Every time I save this application now, if I want to make like a small change, like skinny this up a little bit and hit save, we're seeing version 2 of the app, but Devin is only seeing version 1 of the app. And the way you can tell that, now see the publish button right here? If I say see all versions, we're going to see that Devin is on the live version right here, and we're on the second version right here. So we're kind of editing, while Devin's still seeing the production version. So things like this help you ultimately with application lifecycle management, to where we can kind of edit, and version control is built into this automatically. So pretty slick. Now our last step is just to make sure that we have some data here. If I go back to this fake list, sometimes it takes a little while for it to sync, and that's what we're seeing right now, but we're seeing Bubba Jones now in place. His data is now not correct yet, but so you're seeing that some of these records are a little out of sync. Eventually it will sync up. There we go, AAA Davy Jones. So as you make these changes, we're able to kind of see those changes reflect in the spreadsheet also. All right, so what we showed in this video is ultimately how do we create a simple application using the wizard in just a few minutes to create an application to connect with Excel. So it's a really slick way inside of Power Apps to do this. Now that we have this application done, we can go ahead and edit it and do things like changing the screen size. Oh, I did forget to show that to you. So by the way, if you want to change that screen size, you go over to File up here again. Let me go back here again. You go to File again, in the same place we went to Save, you can go over to App Settings and change the icon, the color, and all those kind of things, and there's your screen size and orientation. We can say, I want to make this a landscape app, and I want to make it a certain size of an app also to where it'll fit inside of a bigger application screen. All right, so that's a quick tour of Power Apps and how you can use it to ultimately connect to things like Excel. I've had a lot of requests in the comments down below about how do you connect to Excel and edit that. So I just want to make this quick video here to show you how to do that also. The requirement for this one is ultimately just having an Excel inside of OneDrive, but you can also use other mechanisms to get to Excel as well. All right, hope you enjoyed this video, and thanks so much for watching. Bye-bye.